Hey everyone, Kerry here with Ask Colab, presented by Rudis. Hey, if you have comments or questions, please leave them at the bottom of this this video. You know, this is I always get the nutrition question, and this wasn't a question that was asked to me, but I think it was something that helped me a lot in later in my career when I started to really pay attention to everything. Right? They always say the details. Right? It always comes down to those small details that are overlooked all the time. And I had a conversation with a guy named Chris Horpel. Chris used to be the former head coach of Stanford University. He was Dave Schultz's high school coach, Mark Schultz's his coach. And so Chris and I would have these talks all the time, and Chris could be a little philosophical. He could go off in different directions, but really, really smart guy, really intelligent guy. And we had this talk about weight one time, and I don't know exactly how the conversation came up, how we got to it, but I think this detail that I picked up from him really helped me later in my career. So the last part of my career, I was a lacto-ovo vegetarian, meaning I ate fish and I ate egg whites, but I didn't eat red meat. I always wanted to try to live this clean, healthy lifestyle to make sure everything was functioning and, you know, properly, and training was good, and it was. I made weight fairly easy. You know, in that last 4 years of my career, and I was wrestling 137. So my point to the story is, one time Chris and I got this conversation, he said, well, what's your best wrestling weight? And I didn't understand what he was asking me, and I said, well, my wrestling weight's 137. He's like, no, what is your best wrestling weight? When you're really getting down to weight and you're doing things in the practice room, at what weight are you doing your best wrestling? And he had told me this story, and I don't know if it was Dave or somebody, but they knew the best weight for themselves, what would be best for them when competing. And what I had figured out when we had that conversation, I started to really pay attention. When was I my fastest? When was I feeling the best? When was I moving the best? When was I not too sluggish? And when was I not too weak? And when I started to really pay attention, what I figured out was, on my way down to 137, I would probably walk around at about, you know, being a vegetarian back then, I'd walk around my heaviest days with like 152, really hydrated. And what I had figured out is, when I hit 145, that was my best wrestling weight. When I started to go below 145 in my descent down to 137 pounds, that's when I would start to get a little weaker, a little more tired. A little more run down. You know, remember, I was going to weigh in for 137 pounds and then get back up. But anytime I exceeded 145, I started to get sluggish. So we had one day night before weigh-ins when I competed internationally, and even my senior year in college. But I didn't start doing this until I started competing internationally. And, you know, so during a competition, I would constantly check my weight. If it was the U.S. Open in 2 days, I was always checking my weight. And, you know, people are like, why are you checking your weight? And I had figured out that 145 was my best weight class. So when I was competing at the U.S. Open or the World Team Trials or at the World Championships, I was trying to maintain 145 pounds. And I felt like that was the best wrestling weight for me, the most optimal for speed, for strength, not being slow. Not being weak, and just felt good. And you know, so, you know, something to think about. It was a detail for me. Maybe it helps somebody out there. But figure out, when you're descending, at what weight do you do your best wrestling? Think about your practice and your training sessions. When are you at peak performance? And, you know, that might be that trick that helps you in a major competition. All right, this is Kerry. So if you have any questions, get them to me through Twitter or reach out to Rudis, and they'll get them to me. Have a good week, and I'll talk to you all next week.